here in the United States is built on a system of checks and balances. At the federal level, we have the Congress and Senate balancing the powers of the President as well as the Supreme Court to keep everyone in check. Here in New Jersey, we have a State Assembly, the State Senate, to balance the power of the governor, and we also have a Supreme Court here as well. In some local municipalities, we have elected mayors balancing elected town officials. And to add another level to that system, some municipalities have a ward system to ensure that all areas of the municipality are represented. We have none of that here in Morris Township. Currently, all five members of the Township Committee seats are held by one small group of one party. There are no checks and balances in Morris Township, and that is not how good government should work. Checks and balances are good for all citizens, whether you're in the majority or the minority. Debate and discussion are healthy, and as many of you know, during my prior two terms in the Township Committee, I sometimes have an alternative point of view on certain issues, and this has provided great opportunities for more discussion amongst our committee members. We now need to bring that balance back to Morris Township to keep our community healthy, and Kathy and I will bring that balance back to Morris Township. Another thing that makes for a strong democracy is transparency. Citizens have a right to be informed, and they should know and understand how their government works and why they make the decisions that they do. Regular communications through a variety of means is critical. Ever since I was first elected, I have sent regular newsletters to residents, updating people about our Township Committee meetings. And now Kathy is taking that to a new level by single-handedly getting video recordings of our Township Committee meetings broadcast on cable television and streaming on the internet. So transparency is something we need more of in Morris Township, and Kathy and I will help deliver that for residents. I also have specific skills that I bring to the table that no other candidate has. I'm a trained engineer with a master's degree in industrial engineering. And when I held office, I used my engineering and analytic skills for the benefit of residents. You'll see some of those examples tonight as we discuss some of the issues that come up. And I look forward to all of those discussions. Thank you.